Now, what if you could turn around any argument with just three words? Psychotherapist Karen Phillip believes it can be done, and she joins us now. It's nice to see you.
Welcome.
Okay, what are these three magical words? Are they I give up?
Are they I am right?
No,
I like those.
They're good. Well, the words are very powerful, but the words have to be used in context, if you like. Imagine that you've got ingredients for a cake. You've got the flour. They're the words. But you need the butter, the sugar, the milk, the eggs to make it that cake. So while the words themselves are powerful, they need to be used in context with the information that's within the book. But saying that, they're all words that make our brains stop. Just for a second, they stop. They're words that we love and our brain ceases. And therefore, when we continue with what we're saying after the word, it alleviates any conflict from escalating. So the way that we use the words are in combination with the rest of the ingredients that we learn within the book. It's to do with NLP language, it's to do with processing, immediately calms it down.
You're so right about the emotion attached to those words.
To lower that conflict that's starting to escalate.
So let's get to the flour, the eggs and the
sugar.
Yes.
So what is the sugar and the butter that you add to the flour to make it all work?
Okay. Well, we often talk about relationships, we think we're talking about ourselves and our partner. But that's not the case. You guys have a relationship in your workplace. We have one with our extended family, with our in-laws, with our children. And all of these are relationships that we need to address. And we often learn our communication style, if you like, through our childhood. Mm. We learn from our parents, who may have been a bit conflictual from time to time. Then we learn from our siblings that I need to yell, I need to argue, I need to raise my voice to be heard, to get what I want. You know, listen to me. And that's what we take into our adult life. But it's only when we learn a different way to actually communicate that we can lower that escalation. And so by learning the processing style of other people, which is all explained, by using the words that they connect to, but we're validating. All those words are validating how the other person feels.
As opposed to dismissing.
Exactly.
Which is what would escalate a fight, right?
And that's what we often do with our communication. We don't listen appropriately. We jump to conclusions. We don't ask the questions. We don't clarify what it is the person is wanting to say, such as, could you explain that a little better? Or if something is said that you feel is a bit harsh, do you think you may be able to reword that, please, so I understand that a little bit differently?
God, you don't argue and have any fun, do you?
I don't. The whole idea of communication is that I have something that I wish to share with you. I have something that I would like you to understand that I am telling you. And by yelling at them, by dismissing them or not valuing what they're saying, has complete opposite effect. Hence why we so often end up in arguments and conflict.
It's all interesting stuff. Dr. Karen Phillip's book, Communication Harmony, is out now. Thank you very much for joining us.
My pleasure. Thank you.